So I sit here and appreciating life down by the river. I've even been for a swim, and I think 7 days ago I contracted a staph infection. And fortunately the hospital system worked out it was a staph infection. But nevertheless, I didn't use the antibiotics. They weren't working. And so I tried my own treatments, which were a combination of propolis, manuka honey, and mainly liquid bandage. And I'm reminded against the injustice of it all the suffering that is caused by bad herb laws, by the Therapeutic Goods Administration, which I prefer to say association with the AMA and particularly pharmaceutical companies that basically prohibit herbs. It's about time that herbs were put in charge of herbalists, or herbalists put in charge of herbs. Having the TGA in charge of herbs is like having Dracula looking after the blood bank. It is such a great shame because people are the donkey's attacking me. People are being there's a perennially pregnant donkey. This is where I live, by the way, down by the river. I've just been for a swim, even though 7 days ago I had golden staph, and it was mainly liquid bandage, which reminds me of the story that a friend, she wasn't a friend at the time, but certainly is now, came racing to me at a festival and said, Ray, I've got golden staph, it's all over my face. And it was all creeping down a neck. And she said, the hospitals can't do anything, the doctors can't do anything, but I know you've got a herb that could help. So we gave a liquid bandage. The next morning I could hear Ray, and I didn't want to go near her. Her face was all black and caked. I can feel it healing underneath, and you can, as I did when I applied it. And the next day, which is the third day of the festival, she was clear of it. There was just a faint pink scar, like when you just pull off a scab on a healed wound. There was just that look. Her golden staph was cured. And knowing that the biggest threat for mankind is our overuse of antibiotics, to the point where one day antibiotics won't be able to be used in operations, it's coming to a critical time. I just think it's so wrong when we have so many herbal antibiotics, from garlic to tea tree to the list goes on, really. You can research them on your own on Dr. Google. But I've used this liquid bandage. But what I want to tell you about is that, because there was a lot of headlines in the paper about this oncoming threat that antibiotics won't work for us anymore, I thought, well, after 5 years of keeping it secret, I'm going to put on my blog just what I've told you now. Do you know, within weeks, the TGA came down hard on me, pressing for a $70,000 fine, threatening to pull down our website if I kept my truth up there. And what was worse, heavy penalties if I reveal what I'm revealing now, because they don't want people to know that one is revealing or holding back on one's truth. It was just so wrong. It went against my grain, but I had no choice but to do what they said and put up an apology that appeared on our website for 6 months, saying that we abused the trust of our customers, and to add insult to injury, at the bottom of their email to me, they said that after the 6 months, they would consider what other penalties I would get for telling my truth, how wrong it is. I'm telling my truth now, and stuff them. It's time for us to stand up to this conspiracy against herbs and natural remedies and put herbalists in charge of prescribing herbs. Herbs like ephedra, which are immediately good for asthma and sinus. I can go on. The list goes on. Anyway, I won't take up any more of your time, but to say herbs do work, and please grow them and use them. Love, Ray.